Your orders to leave here immediately. This cafe is closed until further notice. Clear the room at once.
How can you close me up? On what ground?
I'm shocked to find that gambling is going on in here.
You're winning, sir.
Oh, thank you very much. Everybody out at once.
Joining us on the 680 The Fan Newsmaker line, NFL Hall of Famer Fran Tarkenton. Fran, good morning.
Good morning, guys.
Let me ask you something. If NFL Commissioner Roger Goodell says he didn't see the Ray Rice tape until this week, don't we have to take a man at his word?
I'm a great fan of Roger Goodell, but I think this is a sad time for the NFL. This is another massive cover-up. Certainly, the tape that we've all seen before, the last tape that we had not seen before, showed enough, did it not? They showed this woman being dragged out of an elevator by her husband, or soon-to-be husband. She'd been knocked out. That's enough. But when you hear that the NFL offices back in April had the actual video of Ray Rice hitting his wife and knocking her out in the elevator, and nothing has been done about it. But this is not unusual. I've been in the National Football League since 1961. And I was victim of a doctor in New York and a doctor in Minnesota telling me that, boy, we can shoot you up with this butazolidin in your right shoulder and get you ready to play even though you've got a bad right shoulder and it's separated and it's this and it's that. And I did it because they were the doctor of the team. That led to me having my right shoulder replaced a few years after I got out of football. I have watched the NFL cover up concussions. They had their own in-house doctors just a few years ago tell the world that concussions in football did not lead to brain damage or dementia or Alzheimer's disease or other such things. And then we found out they lied to us. They covered it up. And now they're in courts trying to, you know, go pay $800 million, $900 million back to the old players. They're covering it up. This league has always covered up to take care of its people. They've got more security than the CIA has. They know the background checks of all these people. Yet they signed in Boston Aaron Hernandez, knowing of his track record. But go ahead.
But Fran, why? I just asked this question. Maybe you can answer it to my satisfaction. You're right. They cover it up. Why? Goodell's a smart guy. The NFL, the folks at Park Avenue, they're sharp guys. The game is so big now, any one player getting in trouble, or even handfuls of them, are not going to be a problem. Why try to bury this stuff and cover it up?
Perry. They're doing it. Here's the deal. You see the excitement generated by the NFL football game, right?
Mm-hmm.
We as fans, we love it.
Right.
Don't you think these owners now, they own this team? And they're all billionaires, but that's no different from the ones before. And to win against the other billionaires, and to do it on, they become rock stars and celebrities, and they get all worked up off of this whole thing. They never got this kind of adrenaline running their companies and making their billions. The adrenaline they're getting here is beyond belief. So they don't want to see. So right now, you know, it's a drug-infested business now. Pain drugs are in every locker room. Performance-enhancing drugs are in every locker room. Why? Because it gets the players to play better, play hurt, play at a higher performance. And they look the other way.
Fran, you can
lose
your job for inaction, but you can also lose your job for inaction. Roger Goodell's own words, ignorance is not an excuse, which is what he threw at the New Orleans Saints. Isn't that very short sentence going to end up possibly costing him his job?
I think when I think he's been a great commissioner. I like him a lot. He's a great friend of mine. I'm a supporter of his. He's been great for the NFL. But I think if this thing is uncovered, that people around him, even if he didn't, had this tape, I think with the outrage of the American people, that his job is in jeopardy if that's found out. And I think it's a shame.
828 Rood Awakening here on 680 The Fan. Fran Tarkenton joining us on the 680 The Fan Newsmaker line. He'll be joining us every Thursday morning throughout the NFL football season.